If this were entirely our decision, we'd be more than happy to keep the entire intelligence community off limits to Congress, but there are some political realities in play that make that impossible.
One final thought, if I might. When you left the house this morning wearing that tie, perhaps your wife stopped you in the doorway. Perhaps she told you how good you looked in that tie, how handsome it was. Now, while I'm sure you love your wife, might I suggest you have many reasons to distrust her judgment about that tie. Maybe she has a fond memory of another time you wore it, a sentimental attachment. Or perhaps she knows your tie collection and she's simply glad you didn't choose one of the ties she dislikes. Perhaps she just sensed you were feeling a little fragile. She felt like bucking you up a bit. Now, imagine for a minute, you sit down here with us, and I say to you how much I admired that tie. Instantly, you have another opinion, but you don't know me. There's nothing personal between us. We have no sartorial history. No emotional attachment. Whose judgment are you going to trust? Mine? Or your wife's? The gentleman to my right is a remarkable intelligence analyst. He is skilled in pattern recognition, systems analysis, emergence theories, but, in truth, his greatest asset for you is that you don't know him, and he doesn't know you. He doesn't care about you or your feelings. He just knows what your tie looks like. You can trust him.